You mean you don't recognize me? I'm only the biggest rap star in your apartment complex. And another one. Knocks on the beat. And another one. Come on.
Everybody stop the
press.
Make room for the top of the mountain.
That's me.
Time to laugh at the party. Take a look at me now.
I'm a star, bro. You just don't
know. I love this track. I'm like feeling little brother tonight. Slowly taking my ass to bed, but I'm still awake. That's been a problem lately. I have this problem with insomnia. I've had it since I was like 13, and it's really hard for me to go to sleep. My doctor actually gave me a prescription of Ambien this week, so hopefully sleep is going to be like my best friend once again. I really like to sleep, but I hate when I can't fall asleep. But what do you do when you're laying in bed for 3 hours staring at the ceiling, other than, you know, listen to some music, try to break it down. Anyway, it's been a couple weeks since I posted. A lot's happened. I got a chance to rest, relax. I had friends over for the 4th, and I was too lazy to actually stand over a hot grill, so I ordered barbecue from this place across the street from me. But I did make a homemade nectarine blackberry cobbler with like my homemade little special crust and everything. And I also made a white peach sangria with like fresh peaches and grapes in it. I used a nice Pinot Grigio and a peach brandy that was really nice. I also made this black cherry iced tea with fresh ginger and cinnamon sticks. That was great. One of my friends, one of my neighbors and new friends, she actually took like a small little 16-ounce bottle home with her as a gift. she said it was really good. She liked it a lot. But we had a great time. I had a nice eclectic group of friends over, like people from the business, like Adriana Nicole and Skronker from Adult DVD Talk, and Mr. Pete from Red Light District, and then my neighbors and their, you know, this couple came over, and one of the two, her mom, and one of their other friends. So it was just like a really weird group of people to have together, but it was nice. It was nice to just mix and match people and just kind of let life happen. I've also been like, we did the show again on the 6th, which was, it was cool. You know, we're kind of getting into our groove. This Friday, we're going to have just a play party. We're actually introducing our new set, which we're adding some dungeon furniture by Downtown Willie. We're just getting a 2 pieces of furniture, but it'll be nice to have like that whole little, you know, just to have that, you know, have a different feel from the rest of the sets on the show. And it'll give us some place to play too, so that's gonna be fun. And then Monday, I had the best Monday. I know Mondays for most people are like, you know, dreaded, but this past Monday for me was perfect because my love came by for a while, and we had an opportunity to just be together for a while. With our schedules, it's hard for us to really connect, and the last couple of times he'd tried to come by, I was like 45 minutes away, and you know, we just kept missing each other, you know? We just couldn't connect. So we fixed that this week. He is amazing. Just... we just celebrated an anniversary, and not the anniversary of how long we've been together, but the anniversary of the day that we met, and it was beautiful. I mean, the things we talked about, and we talked about the way that we met, and the love that we share, like all these years later, how much we care about one another, and things that we've experienced, and trials and tribulations, and how much our love has maintained. It's like I found my heart, you know? Such a girl. I love him, though. It's actually ironic because this boy that I had been kind of fooling around with for a while, a couple months ago, for my regular blog readers, they know him as Anthony, and he's younger, and I kind of broke things off with him because he was so, like, not fun anymore, and he had been, you know, things just got messier and messier over the weekend, and I just had to kind of put him in check and tell him that, you know, you need to put your girls in check, because it's not my responsibility to, like, you know, handle your business for you. And it was, you know, I had celebrated this wonderful day with my love, and then the very next day I start getting all these random emails from this guy's girlfriend about, you know, who he wasn't with at the time we were together, but it was like she was like so worried about whether or not I wanted her man. I had to tell her, you know, we throw the little fish back here. We don't keep the little fish. I like big fish. My love is as big as they come, so I'm not leaving him for anybody. Ever. Speaking of which, my newest toy, the director that was telling me that my pussy was gonna belong to him, we've been playing a lot lately. I know, I'm so fucking weak, like, I'm so bad, but he understands, like, now he understands, and we've had the conversation about how I'm just, you know, I'm just having a good time, and, but I think we're both kind of crushing on each other a little bit, and, it's always nice to have little crushes. Because the little crushes make the real thing that much sweeter. My love thinks it's cute that I get little crushes on boys from time to time, because he always, you know, remembers to tell me that I'm not going anywhere ever. I belong to him forever with all my heart.